Scotty McClure, and we are, of course, live on Facebook Live. 10 o'clock sharp, nothing gets past me. Sunday night, of course, Sunday the 23rd of October, 2016. I hope you're well and you have had a wonderful week. And this is the start of our Facebook Live broadcast. Now, I've just been joined by a black Labrador, so all is well in the world. If you don't know who I am, let me introduce myself. I'm Scotty McClure, capital S, small c, O, double T, I, E. That's the Scotty. And the McClure, capital M, small c, capital C-L-U-E, Scotty McClure, Dinky Doo. We are, of course, live on Facebook, and we are global. This is our fifth show, and we're going to give lots of shouts out to lots of you wonderful people who have decided to join us tonight. Tony's with us, Jim's with us, Jim McIntyre, George Raffin, Mark Jones, Robbie Bain, Frank McElroy. Good evening, Scotty, says, always the gent, Frank. Marvellous, I like that. David Hammond's watching, a very wonderful broadcaster there, top man, David. Callum Slight is watching, good evening, Scotty Dinky Doo. Jerry Cart is watching, Wajahat Hashmi is watching, Dinky Doo, Scotty. Catherine Shaw's watching, hi, Scotty, says Catherine. And a kiss. And William Black's with us, Robbie Bean, Woogo! Brian McWilliams is here, Matthew McGoldrick, all right, Matthew, John Gray, Sean Jimison, Jonathan Fernston, and Ewan McIntyre, Andy Taylor, Lynn Donnelly's watching. This is absolutely fantastic, folks. We have a huge audience. Now, just to let you know, our combined figure of viewing and listening is 26,000. So with tonight's show, hopefully that will get us up to 30,000 in the last few programs since we started. A big G, give that man a pound, says William Black. Yes, thank you, William. Dinky Doo, Scotty. Lawrence from sunny Stornovach. Ah, good evening to you now. Hakimachi. Hello, sir, says David. Thank you very much, David Hammond. Of course, he is a wonderful broadcaster. I don't know why he's thanking me. It is a fact of life. Matthew McGuigan says, hi. Roddy Martin is watching. A wonderful society figure there, Roddy. And it's great to know he is to the fore. Hi, Scotty boys, says Denise Carroll. Lynn Donnelly is my hairdresser. Of course she is. And look at the quality job I get. Fantastic. Short back and sides, and not much on the top. Dinky Doo, where do you wear your cap in bed, Scotty? Of course. Only if it's very cold. If I'm warm enough, I will take it off. I have taken it off before. And good evening, Scotty. Hello from sunny Glasgow, says FTP. Fantastic. Steve Burrows, hi, Scotty. My goodness me, I cannot believe the number of you that are out there. This is tremendous. This is a global show, of course, so we are right across the world. So do let us know where you're watching Scotty McClure right now. And, of course, the rest of you, use your social media well and wisely. Tell 10 to tell 10 to tell 10 to tell 10 about Scotty McClure on Facebook Live, just for you. Dinky Doo, 10 o'clock sharp on Sunday evenings. Gordon Allen is here. Hi all, says Gordon. Hal Howe, good evening, Scotty. Any chance of a shout out to Andy Tigger? Of course there is. Dinky Doo, Scotty McClure, says Gary Alba Kelly. So there we are, obviously a Scotsman. Sean Jimison says, hi, Scotty. Fantastic stuff. And we've got it all in Facebook there. Hal Howe likes the video, of course. Tremendous. We recorded a little video this morning. Now, watch out for these on a Sunday morning, and they will be coming across the Facebook site throughout the day. This is a little promo, as we call it in the business, a promotional video. Just a few seconds. Shout out, says Matthew Neal. Richard Frediani is watching. Richard Frediani, perhaps one of the finest newsmen in the country. You look at your television sets, you will see that name, Richard Frediani, wonderful, wonderful news editor, top man. I worked with him many, many years ago in the newsroom, and he is just different class. Terry Taylor's here from Paxton in the Scottish Borders. I know it well. I know the Borders well. Galla Shields, Selkirk, the home of the Bannock, and all that sort of stuff. Love watching in a Sunday evening, says Tony Sanctus. Thank you, Tony. It's just something different, isn't it? That's what I say. You know, you get an old guy in tweeds. I always remember going to an agent in 1980. He said, what do you want to do? I said, I want to broadcast, sir. It said television and radio. I said, "Oh, television. Where's the Labrador?" says Robbie. "The Labrador is down here, Robbie. He's having a wee sleep on the floor." "All right, Scotty. Watching in Brum tonight," says wee Rona Roo. "She's in Birmingham." Absolutely fantastic stuff. Shout out to Scott the Robot from Sean Jimson. Luca Ventisi, ha ha ha, Matthew. Watching in sunny Glen Boyg, Gary, Irene, Greg, and Callum Stewart, the Stewart family watching. Ian Cook's watching up there in Bonnie Dundee. Hello, Ian. A very, very fine, creative gentleman, Ian Cook, of course, a wonderful organist and pianist. Terrific piano player. "Can you dab for us, says Armin?" Of course I can dab for you, Armin. Right, there you are. I've just dabbed. "What's the hot topic tonight?" says Gordon Allen. Well, Gordon, we had Shug on earlier, and he was suggesting we discuss the Highland clearances, now don't panic, as a background to the way Scotland is. A shout out from Cobe Coal Fires, says William Black. Ah, these are the days. Yes, get in, says Luca. Would you take the BBC if someone offered it to you? What do you mean? Would I take it as a toy for Christmas morning? Or would I take the controller of BBC Scotland's job? Or would I take the Director General's job? I mean, who knows? You know, lots and lots of experience. Used to listen to you on Hallam FM. Fantastic, Scotty. Hi, Scotty, watching from Eldersley. A shout out to Hazmat Mahmood from Isa. Of course, Isa, dinky do to you. Amin says, thanks for the dab. No problem at all. We're a dab hand at the dab. I can tell you that. Right, Scotty. What about the Syrian weans who look 45? Well, some of us do look older than we are. Yours truly here, of course. What's your thoughts on the monarchy being parasites? Yes or no? No, they are certainly not parasites. They cost us 52 pence a year each, and they bring in billions to the economy. So we need to get that right. Bobby Gracie's watching, a very, very fine gentleman there. Yes, top businessman. Of course, he's having a good old swatch at the programme tonight. Yvonne Boyd McKinnon. Hello, Scotty, from Yvonne in the Scottish Borders. Lovely to hear from you. Alan Blacklaw's watching. Hi, Alan. Listen to you on Century, says Lisa Wilson, and sends me two lovely kisses. Have you seen Daniel Blake yet? I came out in tears and was hugged over it. You have to be full of mince to have anything to do with the BBC. Well, no, we all have something to do with the BBC. We pay them a fortune every year. Shout out to Baldy, says Sean. What number to call you, says Wajahat. Well, we don't have a number, Wajahat, and last week we tried to take some Skype calls that didn't quite work out because they were coming through on the other devices. Good evening, Scotty. From Kilmarnock, says Kevin Malcolm McGregor. Jean Perret says, yes, parasites. No, no, wrong, 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 Sean. Aidan Gilhooly says, Skype! Yes, go on, Aidan. Skype if you want. Scotty.McClue is my Skype handle. Angela Walters is watching. Callum Watson. What's happening, big man? Bring back Clan FM, says William Black. Dinky do in capital letters, says Stephen Nunnery in Manchester. Angela Goodlett's watching. Scotty, a shout out to Tommy, who's gutted he can't make it tonight. He's working hard. Yes, no bother at all. Tommy, I pray. John Cummings says Skype. Absolutely, Skype away there, John. How many stations have you been on, Scotty? I think about 30. And contrary to public belief, I do not get sacked from these stations. I move on because somebody else wants the programme. So there you are. And shout out for Andrew. Try Messenger, says Denise Carroll. Now, guys, I'll only take messages for Scotty McClue. So, you know, there's no point in sending through silly messages with the wrong name on them or something like that. And there's no point in saying something too silly because I won't read it out. Oh, aren't I just such a naughty boy for not doing that. Dinky do, says Den O'Donnell. Angela Goodlett says, love it, keep going. A shout out, says Scott McLaughlin. Andy McCrory's watching. Hello, Andy, dinky do to you. Call me Wadge, says Wajahat Hashmi. No bother, Wadge it is, Wadge. So, what is your take on the clearances? Well, obviously, this was a depopulation of Scotland through social injustice. Cobe says, a shout out, Scotty. Come on, Scotty, what's your view on Donald Trump? So, there we are. Well, Who would you prefer in there, Donald or Hillary? Bit of a choice there, isn't it, actually? I put up on a Twitter poll, who would you like? Would you like Trump? Would you like Hillary or McClue? And McClue got 74%. That's not too bad. Callum shouted out to you, says Christopher. Yes, I did. Callum, he shouted out to you. Paul Jones, Dinky Doo, Scotty, revert to telephonic debates. Stop the shout-outs, says Brian Murphy. Brian, you try and stop the shout-outs. I mean, at the moment, I'm afraid that's what people are wanting. We can get on to telephonic debate, but everybody on here is wanting a bit of a shout-out. Peter Ewing says he's loving it. Scotty, how bad was honey? Isa says a shout-out to Suvanali. Yes. Do you watch The Apprentice? Hey, you're fired. Right. Oh, that settles you all down. Alvarez and McGregor, Scotty. Yes, McClue for president, says Angela. I quite agree, Angela. And McClue for president. Yes, there's another one, says Den O'Donnell. Well done. I miss Harambee. Do you miss Harambee? Yes, I miss Harambee. Shout out for Rachel. Hello, Rachel. Say hi to wee Callum, says Gary. Hi, wee Callum. And a shout out to Paul Tulloch. Andrew Lamb is watching, so there we are. You've got to look after your customers. It's all very well saying revert to telephonic debate. Now, who else have we got? Yes. What's your thoughts on IndyRef 2? Well, it will happen. And if you notice, the newspapers have actually changed their tune. They're coming round, realising that Scotland needs to be independent. The wonderful Kerry Miles is watching. Dinky Doo to you, Kerry. Fantastic. McClue for president, I say. Snowballs or blue ribbons, says Robbie. Ooh, advertising now. You sent me out for eating mini eggs, drinking, and then I offered you one and you shouted at me. Not at all. Good evening again, Scotty. Remember my website? So there, yes, we'll remember your website. Good impression of Alan Sugar. You're fired. Right, don't waste my time with all that stuff. I'm not interested. Right, what's your thoughts on Vladimir Putin? I think he's actually a very fine fellow. I mean, the Russian ships going through the sea, people are trying to make political capital out of that. But in actual fact, that exercise was planned months and months ago. And what they'd be saying on the bridge of the ship is, hello, carrier, this is HMS, do you need us over? Safe passage, we'll stick with you. Ha, 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 ha! Ha, says Christopher. Seth says a shout out to Seth Johnson, no problem. Sinodine, a shout out to Shahid. McClue, says Den, fantastic. And Big Man, says Callum, hello, how are you? Yes. Would you go back onto any radio stations you worked for in the past? Yes, I mean, I've done that. I've retraced my steps. The problem is I fatten the radio stations up, make them worth millions and millions of pounds. The bosses sell them, and McClue has to move on. IndyRef 2, says David Lafferty. Absolutely, Scotty. Please say hi to my gorgeous girlfriend, Kathy, says Paul Jones. Hi, Kathy. Paul thinks you're gorgeous. Who else have we got? Can you shout out to Paul? Says Simon. Yes, I can. Christopher says, Callum. Fantastic. James Morgan's watching. What have we got? Keep a beard. I don't have a beard, dear boy. A separate show for shout outs, says Gordon. And then we can get down to discussions. If you want to give me a Skype call, Scotty.McClue. Hi, Scotty. Why are the Scots so different in the thinking and social issues then than our neighbours down south? Why are English nationalists racist when Scots nationalists are more about governance? Well, to explain to you, Scottish nationalists and English nationalists are the very, very antithesis of each other. There is no connection. The Scottish nationalist is a great, caring, thoughtful person with a social conscience looking for justice. The English nationalist is a very, very right-wing creature who does not love their fellow men. So there you are. Shout out to Andrew, of course, Andrew Payton. Mr. McClue, can you be my bobber job boy? I've got 50 pence. It used to be 5p, a shilling bobber job. I remember cleaning out a huge garage for a shilling, for 5p. Simon says, a shout out to me. Yes, of course you can have a shout out. Scottish nationalists are about governance, says Kevin Malcolm McGregor. Yes, of course. But I mean, you know, there's absolutely no doubt that Hi, Scotty, is that you or a double that I met in Gourock last week? Says Jed. Well said, Scotty, says Gordon. Shout out to Mim Scoot. Do you never age, you lovely man, says Kerry Myers. Oh, Kerry, carrying a little bit of weight. I saw your lovely dad, he's lost a bit of weight. Amazing. What about all these single mothers that are disgraced to the nation? Shout out to Senga, a shout out conversation, my goodness me. We've just passed 250 comments. Here's somebody ringing me, who's this? I've just missed a call there, absolutely. If you want to ring me again, Scotty.McClue. Here, I like that, I want you to say that. Shout out, shout out. Shout out, right, that's enough of all that. There's no point just shouting out. There's Callum McMillan there wanting one. We miss the phone-ins, the debates and your views, says Angela Walters. Angela, I miss the phone-ins. We need to get this sorted. I'm worried about my friends in the radio companies because radio's a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful thing. You'll never whack it, but I do worry about them. Thanks for your thoughts on my question about nationalism. My thoughts too, says Andrew Imrie. Quite right. Andrew, it's not even nationalism. These are just facts. McClue just tells you the facts. I mean, I'm not really a great political animal. First time tuning in and already I love it, says Sarah Carroll. Dinky-doo, Sarah. Hi, Lauren, says Sandy. Hi, Sandy. All the rest of it. Here we are. Ha, 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 says Christopher. Who have we got here? Let's see if we can take this. Hello, is that Sean? Hello, is that Sean? Just bear with me, folks. Is that Sean? Hello, Sean? Can you hear me? Right, he's obviously panicked and nipped off. Century Radio, Scotty, remember seeing you there. Do you do the cooking by the books, says Simon? Yes, put in another spoonful of that. Oh, I forgot the eggs. Shout out to Josh. Josh McDonald, absolutely. Ah-ha-ha, a shout-in, says Stuart Hay. Fantastic, Stuart. A bit of a shout-in. We like that. Right, Sandy says... Would Lauren shout out to us, Scotty? Yes, Scotty. Dave Doubledex, the host of Eden FM Radio Breakfast in Penrith, Cumbria. A big hello if you can. I know Penrith very, very well. Absolutely. I used to come down to Eden Hall and Langwathby. Langwathby. Ooh, lovely. Carlisle. Fantastic. Technology has made massive bounds. Come on, Scotty, living in the land of shout-outs. Come on, people. Donate to Scotty and bring it to the here and now. Now, folks, you don't have to donate, but seriously, if you're feeling flush and you've got a bob or two, pound notes, dollars, euros, anything you like, then I miss your comments, says Paul Jones. He says something naughty, but I'm not reading that out. Shout-out to my daughter, Abby, before bedtime, says Angela. Dinky-doo, Abby. Off to your bobos now. Save money, says Denner. Oh, no, he's talking nonsense. No, you're silly, Den. You're a silly boy. Very, very clever boy, wasting your time on here. A shout out to Leroy, says Joshua. Joshua McDonald there. Fantastic. Now, what I was going to tell you, yes, very, very important. So if you do want to make a donation, go to www.scotty-mcclue.com and you will see the PayPal there. And anything you do send in will be put to very, very, very good use indeed. It will be used to buy little bits of equipment. Like I've had a webcam that's very noisy. I also did YouTube today. Streamed live for the first time, so go on to YouTube later, not now, later. All right, Cob, shout out to Isa, says Supan. Gregor, says Callum Watson. Fantastic, there we are, that's wonderful stuff. Now, what's really going to do, if you wonder what I'm doing, actually, I'm just putting on one of my mitts. There you go. See, absolutely. There we go. The old shooting mittens, because they're very good for operating the buttons here. A shout out to Denise, Sarah and Gordon. A phone, says Brian. Yes, we will look at phones, all that sort of stuff. That's what, as I say, if you're feeling flush, feel free to donate and I shall spend it wisely on equipment. McClue's spent all of his money, all his life. Here's somebody coming through to us. Hello. We'll see if we can get this done. Hello? Hello? Is that Sean? Hello, Sean. Can you hear me? Wait a minute. Bear with me. Let me see if I can just get the... Are you still with me? Oh, I used to be your drama teacher. Oh, how fantastic is that? You are a top man. What I'm doing, Sean, I'm actually seeing if I can get you on air here. So just bear with me. Hold on. How's that, Sean?
That's better.
That's better. Big voice. You're talking to the nation. What's happening, nation? Sean, that's fantastic. Lovely to hear you. You're our first caller tonight. And dinky doo. There we are. That's Sean calling there. Brave boy, that was excellent. And of course, he was live to the nation. No, that's fine, says Gregor Fraser. Bobby McAllister, hi, Sean. Robbie says, use a tin with a bit of string instead. Do you remember that? You used to get two tins and a wee bit of string. Over 100 of you have had shout outs. Sandy says, I'll see you tomorrow. Hi, mate, says Bobby. Don't call me mate. I don't really like that. I think that this mate thing has come in from it's Cockney. It's a bit of Cockney, and we don't want it in Scotland. Absolutely. A shout out to Maggie from Basford. Yes, of course I can, Steve. Grant Elger GG's watching. The Hebe Simpson of Scotland. Who was Hebe Simpson? Anybody know? Get onto your Facebook there and tell us. Here we go. It's going absolutely mental, says Grant Elder. Of course it is. I told you that. I warned you. I said to you, this is McLuganing on. It will be very, very popular. And you're going, me and the taxis. Hi, Lon and Rachel, says Sandy. Too many dafties out tonight, says Grant. Takes one to know one, Grant. Did you watch the game today, Scotty? Always watch the game. Here's John calling. Hello, John. Just a wee minute, bear with me. Right, we'll see if you get. Hello, John. Hello, John. Can you hear me? Oh, call ended. He panicked. Don't panic when you're ringing up. There's no need to. A shout out to Leroy. This is super mate, says Nicholas Tavares. Yes, absolutely. Shout out to Andy, of course. Now, who have we got here? Impressive mittens. A few of us would have some leadership re-Indy 2 with the mittens. Well, I may well take a leadership position in Indy 2 if we reform the whole broadcasting and media thing. McClue might look after that for you guys. Good luck to all the lads awaiting the results of their gas exams from the developing course in Linlithgow. G. Hamilton, fantastic. Yes, gas exams, very, very important, you know, because, well, for obvious reasons. I don't think I need to go into that. But because we love you gas guys when you come round and you know what you're doing. I always remember when my boiler was elderly and it had broken down, and I had the rep in from one of the gas companies, and I said, switch it on. And she said, no, I don't think I want to switch that on, in case it fires up. I said, oh, no, fire up. That's what's wrong with it. Good evening, says Mirren. Good evening to you. Don't worry, we'll get there. We will stick with you. You are worth it, says Lisa Wilson. Lisa, thank you. Of course, I am worth it. I'm only interested in helping you lot out, right? It seems to me a bit ridiculous that somebody says, well, old McClure, yes. Is he not knocking on a wee bit? And that sort of stuff. Though somebody said this week, what was it? They said, oh, it's a wee bit sad that an old guy's still broadcasting. I mean, for goodness sake, do you say that when Prince Philip turns up to open the local store? You say, well, are you not 95 now? Dinky doo, Scotty, let's hear it for McClure's Pies, says Christopher Anthony Smith. McClure's Pies, you'll never get a finer pie. And of course, the vegetarian lettuce slice in the rich chicken sauce. Skype. Yes, Skype, no problem, Callum, but somebody panicked. That's the stuff. Callum Watson, talking a lot of nonsense. Callum, there's no point in putting silly stuff down, so because I won't read it out. So you can forget that. There's Den saying he's innocent. We've got his word for it, so we'll press on with that. Now, let me just revert to my Facebook here. I have it beside me, and I just need to check a couple of things. So let me just revert to the Facebook and see what you're all saying. I'll tell you what I will do. I'll give you that website in case we've got a generous person that says, no, I can give you something, Scotty. There we are. So it's www.scotty, Hyphen. Now, don't forget the hyphen. I think that's very important. Hyphen MCCLUE.com. There we are. And I'll put that in. Does that look all right? www. Hold on a minute. I think we've got more than one eye there. Yeah, you don't want to. Well, you could. Well, we've got two eyes, but I mean, there's more than one eye in that. So backspace, and we'll replace it with a T. Right, I think that looks better. Good. And I'll pop that in. So there you are, guys. So what you should see now, if you look on my Facebook page, is www.scotty hyphen. No, it's got an underscore. Who put an underscore in that? That's just ridiculous. Right, so we've got the underscore. There we are. There's the hyphen. That's looking a bit better, I would say. Yes. Scotty-McClue.com. I'm still here, dears. Don't panic. Don't panic. There we are. Just going to pop that over. That's excellent there. So if you go to my Facebook page, just above where it says, there's Ashley Young's followed me, and Lewis Duncan likes the video. Fantastic. Scotty-McClue.com. So if you go on to that, guys, that should sort that out. That would be absolutely marvelous. I'll just pop that one off. Here's somebody Skyping us. Hello? Hello? Right, hang on. Hello? Can you hear me? Hello? Can you hear us? So there we are. I lived in Emmerdale, was never arrested. I lived in Emmerdale and was never arrested in an accident, he says. A shout out to Ben, of course. Hi, Scotty Dinky-Doo from Big Jim. That's Jim Thompson there. That is absolutely tremendous, Jim. Quality. Hello? Can you hear us? Hello? 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 You going to speak? Hello, can you hear me? That was fantastic. That was good, folks. Hello? Hello? No, I don't think he's there. Right, we might just give up on the Skype stuff because it's holding stuff up. Right, and a shout out to Habib. A shout out to Dawson. Fantastic. And who else have we got? Shout out to Josh McDonald and a shout out to Ian Mayer from Lauren. Skype is terrible at streaming. You're better with another app. Well, we shall look into that. I can tell you that that is not a problem. I'm looking into all sorts of things here. I've got some tremendous things here. Just be back with you in a second. Don't dash off. Well, there you go. Excuse me. There you go. Just sorting the dog out there. Fantastic. Right. Nearly lost my bonnet. It's pretty windy up here tonight, I'll tell you that. Bobby McAllister says, a shout out to me. And a shout out to Tam, says Ben Monhen. Absolutely. Hey, buddy. Best wishes, says Alan Mack. Sandy, Celtic or Rangers, Scotty? Well, they're both fantastic. They really are. So I think the two teams should get together. And we would have Glasgow United. What about that then, eh? Aye, we can all hear you. Get on with it, says David McGuinness. No problem at all, David. Thank you for telling me not to give up on radio, says Tony Mac. Tony, you never, ever, 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 ever give up. What would be the point in that? You get people saying, what was it? I had one guy saying, oh, hi, yes, I, you used to be famous, didn't you? And all that kind of stuff. Hello? Hello? Can you hear me? There we go. Right, now I think I might just give up on that. There we go. Just put that in the back of a drawer. Joe Cochran says, lol, absolutely. Gardens in East Fife. Fantastic stuff. Good. I mean, I remember being an old firm game, and I was climbing over the fence, and a policeman came up. He says, what do you think you're doing? I said, just climbing over the fence. He went, go back in until the end of the game. So there we are. Mind comments on my new singing clips, Mr. You're looking amazing for 30. Thank you very much. A shout out to Luca, of course. No problem at all. Ask Eddie, when will he marry me? Well, no, you ask Eddie yourself. Please can you give a shout out to my wife, Samantha? Yes, I can indeed. No problem at all. And there's Callum. I don't know what he's telling us there. Scotty, do you want to donate to me? Fantastic. I love it. No, listen, I'm ignoring you. Stop Skyping. Right, a shout out to Beth Gourley, of course, and a shout out to Ishan. Shout out to Glenn Thompson. Tremendous. There we are. These shout outs are amazing. Blair says hi. John Toms, marvellous man there, super businessman and a great broadcaster. John's watching. A shout out to Andy, absolutely just back, absolutely brilliant, says John Toms. Thank you, John. Marvellous. John's been broadcasting on another station. And a shout out to Andy, please. Nicholas, there's no point in writing silly, silly things because I just won't see it. All right. Hi, Scotty. Good to see you. And three kisses from Margaret Hemphill Sweeney. What a wonderful name. Bobby again, please, says Bobby. They're certainly not. Coming round again, a piece of nonsense. A shout out to Ronnie Dyla. Yes, of course. No problem at all. Come back, Scotty. We miss the banter, says Catherine Scully. Absolutely. A shout out for all my clan are all here, and a shout out to Nicholas. Now, do you know, for instance, when we're talking about the Highland clearances, they wanted to clear the land for sheep. Hi, glad to see you, Scotty. Lots of love from Greenock, says Charles McNab. Grant says, favourite place in Scotland. I take it he's talking about Hebe Simpson there. Moira's in Toronto. Marvellous. Dinky do. Scotty, Craig B here. Give me a take on Trump or Clinton. I really wouldn't want to have either of them if I was pushed, but I really don't think I'd want Hillary Clinton, to be quite honest, and well, Trump. Do you know what I mean? This is why I can't stand, because I'm not an American citizen. That's all that's standing in the way. Otherwise, I would be up there giving it my fellow Americans. Right, John says, tell us about the guy who called your show hours before it started and you kept waiting to the end of the show. Yes, this was a guy who he called one night to the phone in, and I said, Brian, and he went, yes. And I said, how are you tonight? And he said, I'm angry, very angry. I said, who's making you angry, Brian? He said, you. Anyway, he said, 2 hours, 2 hours I've been waiting to get on this telephone. I said, I won't keep you a second longer. And I cut him off. Wee drop of water here. Who's this Skyping? Hello? 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 Can you hear me? Hello? Mr. Skyper? There's no point Skyping and hanging up, guys. Right, a shout out to Boris. Yes, hello, Boris. Yeah, call you got us in some trouble over all that Brexit stuff, didn't you? So there we are. If we get into the debate, you talk and we type, says Lisa Wilson. Yes, absolutely, Lisa. If we get into the debate, because remember, this is only show five. And it's only between half an hour and an hour, 40 minutes, something like that, on a Sunday night, just to see if there was actually a demand for it. Because if I'm honest about it, my ambition is to get a massive global phone-in out on all social media platforms. That's my actual ambition. Excuse me here, it's getting a bit warm in here with all this tweed on. I'll just give myself a wee tidy up. Oh, that's better. Right. Sorry about that there, actually. That's very warm, very warm. All that kind of thing. I'm over in Spain. A shout out to Rachel and Sophie, says David Halliday. Absolutely, no problem at all. Is that Robbie, would you stop, Mr. Cheeky? Turn the phone volume up, Scotty. A shout out to PC Paul. PC Paul, dinky doo, good evening. La 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 la. Hello from East Kilbride. Oh, hello, East Kilbride. How tremendous. And what's in your fridge, Scotty? Well, not a great deal at the moment, I have to say. I think there's some olives and a little bit of juicy feta or feta. Spell it, I mean, write it down to me here and spell it. Scotty, don't you think Nicola Sturgeon's like a cheese grater on your ears? No, I certainly do not. Nicola Sturgeon is the most organized, well-turned-out, thoughtful, clever politician that this country's seen for hundreds of years, hundreds of years. I mean, so much rot set into this country when Margaret Thatcher set about it. You know, it really did. It really did. There's no doubt about that. But there we are. But as I say, I'm not really a political man. Scotty, you could get your friends to video call you on Messenger. Yes, Lisa. Now, I wondered about Messenger. Everybody's been asking me to get Messenger. Do you prefer your Maze on or off the cob? Yes. I seriously, Adam, I'm stop putting silly things down because I will not read it out, to be quite honest to you. A shout out to Jamie. A shout out to Finlay. Dinky doo to you, Finlay, of course. Marvelous stuff. Who's this? Hello. Hello. There we are. Hello. No answer. Right, there we go. Margaret says, might I say you're looking very fetching tonight, Scotty? Thank you very much, Margaret. Yes, I could do with losing a stone or two, obviously. There we are. Are you doing the show from home, Scotty? Yes, I'm doing it from the old study. So there we are. Saves on a studio, doesn't it? When was the last time you were on the paddle steamer Waverley? Andrew MacDonald says, Andrew, I would love to go on the Waverley. I haven't been on for far too long, and it was a dear, dear old friend of mine that put the engines in the Waverley. It was the chairman of Rankin and Blackmore of the Eagle Foundry in Greenock. The foundry, I think, was damaged during the war, and he put the engines of the Waverley, Jim. And I remember I sat in a committee with him, and he was such a marvellous man, interesting, interesting man, the late Jim Ferrier, tremendous. And he rang Rankin and Blackmore. You'll see if you go on the Waverley, they were the engineers from Greenock. So, right, a shout out to Lewis and Hal, Scotty, says Fletcher. Absolutely, no problem at all. So we can do that for you. And of course, all the wonderful Clyde steamers, I do miss them. The turbines, when the turbines came in around the turn of the last century, around 1900, fantastic. Are you bald, says Den? No, I have a fine head of hair, Den. You can just see it at the back. I am certainly far from bald. So there we are. Kevin, grow up and support your own country and stop supporting London Tories when they cut Scottish jobs every single time. Get a grip, says John. Fantastic. Good for you, John. Scotty, you bam, I'm enjoying your show from Baltic Castle Milk, the Chateau Olay. Mick Thompson. Hello, Mick. Dinky doo to you. Scotty, I've PM'd your pals, says David. No problem at all, David. A shout out to Kimberly. Yep. Are you a Spice Boy? Says stop all this nonsense. Love to Davy in Spain, says Den. Right, Daft Den, who's on here, who's got a huge IQ. I don't know why he's being so silly. Mind you, I've got an IQ of 164. So there we go. What have we got here? Who have we got here? Hello. There we are. Hello. Hello. Dinky doo. So there we go. Now, what I'm going to do actually, I think we'll just put this device off because people are ringing to try it out and then panicking, of course, when I say hello. Robbie says he's a Paisley. Shout out to Elizabeth Walker from Olivia. Absolutely. Well said, John, says Shug McGinty. Good for you, Shug, and well said, you, Shug. You come out with a tremendous amount of common sense, I have to say. I was talking to somebody this week and they said, Scotty, your show is absolutely brilliant. We love it, but you're a wee bit close to the camera. I have to actually read it, to be quite honest with you. Right, there you are. Hi, Stuart, says Norma. Hi, Norma. No Sandy Howden tonight, says Gordon. Now, Sandy, pardon me, Sandy's the last of the Labour supporters, the last of the old dinosaurs there. Tremendous. And we like, you know, I mean, a dinosaur is always somebody to go and see. Good evening, Scotty, says William Reid. Kevin Malcolm McGregor says, I love the logic of some folk. If you're not a nationalist, you're a Tory. Oh my word. So there you are. But please, folks, whatever you're doing, remember that Scottish nationalists are nothing to do with British nationalists. They're completely the opposite. They're the antithesis, the very antithesis. So there you are. Watch your Skype, Scotty. I've switched off just now, Josh, because I don't think it was working. A shout out to Finlay. Hi, Finlay. Lovely to hear you. And who else have we got? Give Jack a shout out, says George. No problem at all. Do you just do Sunday, Scotty? Yes, I just do a few minutes on a Sunday night to see if you guys like it. And if there's a demand, then we'll get sorted and start putting in equipment and things like that and get the show on the go. Also, check out the YouTube stream live this afternoon, really just as an experiment. So it looks quite funny. But try it out as an experiment because I think what we should be doing, we'll be back doing your phone-in radio show again, Scotty. I love that. It was very, very amusing. Absolutely. Well, who knows? Kevin says, I'm a socialist, less borders, not more. No, well, you're not really putting in borders. As I say, Scotland's independence is economic, it's not actually political. So it's economic. You could actually say to the media during Indyref to butt out. My nephew Gary McDonald's the first mate in the Waverley, so we need to come and bring your squeeze box for a tune. Andrew, I was going to actually get the squeeze box and give you a tune tonight. A shout out to Karina. Absolutely. We love it, says Steve Burrows. Thank you very much, Steve. Very much appreciated. And a shout out to Jack. So there we are. It's all going, it's just all going up in front. You'll see all this at home. I would imagine you'll be seeing what I'm seeing. A shout out to Buster, says Finlay. Hi, Buster. Dinky doo to you, of course. Wee touch of water for Mr. McClure. Ooh. Tremendous stuff. There's Sean calling again. Hello? Can you hear us, Sean? No, it's hanging up. Right, we'll just put this absolutely off. So there we are. I'll put it out. Shall I go into flight mode? Yeah, I'll get to flight mode. That's what it's all about, right? There we go. No, I worked out what that's about. So they are. Can you tell her to move it, Scotty? Thanks very much, says Angie. So there you go. Skype, that's still on the go, says Stuart. Ooh, wee touch of sarcasm there. Marvellous, we love it. Yeah, a shout out to Seamus McGeady. Seamus McGeady, a shout out to you. Tremendous. How's the time doing? For goodness sake, folks, I'll have to go soon. Getting well past my bedtime, and I've got my work in the morning, you know. People to see, places to go. Oh no, yes, old McClure's a busy, busy man. Economics, not political. The Nicola said independence transcends everything, including the national wealth. Well, yes, I mean, last year, we in Scotland sent in excess of £40 billion. In excess of £40 billion. Right, that's that. That's shut down. You will not hear that again. I could tell you. Eddie, you're going to marry me. It's all kicking off big time. Yahoo! Says Robbie Bain. Absolutely, of course it is. Kevin says, show me social and economic argument for independence, and I'll vote for it. I will not, however, vote for the SNP. You don't need to vote for the SNP. The biggest mistake that Labour ever made was giving up on their roots, giving up on their whole raison d'etre, and not backing independence for Scotland. That's for that ridiculous speech by Gordon Brown. I mean, I do not know. Scotland has no debt. Well, it doesn't have a huge debt. Is your dad, says Callum. Yes, he is, Callum. He's a lovely, lovely, lovely man. And he's been gone for, wait, do we see, 20 years, Big Archie. Scotty, with a medium like this, national broadcasters and media outlets' days are numbered. A lot of people get their news and entertainment from the web these days. Scotland cannot have debts as part of a devolved administration. Absolutely, John. Good stuff. Well, we don't have debt. We're giving it all away. I mean, if there'd been any black hole that'd have dropped us like a hot tatty, I could tell you that. The BBC, says Norma Young. And I actually rang the BBC one day. It was very funny, and the lady was very proper. And she said, British Broadcasting Corporation, good afternoon. BBC, no, BBC, good afternoon. And I said, oh, good afternoon. I said, it's Scotty McClure here. She went, to listen to you, I love it. Can that come back? It's wonderful, isn't it? Could you not get it in here? Gordon says, get in there, Scotty. Fantastic. So there we are, Scotty. What's that? Something, my mate, Tammy, mate. Abby heard that this time, says Angie. Yes, absolutely, Scotty. Abby heard that this time, mate. Thanks. So a shout out to. Yes, I think that's. Shout out to all my family and friends, says Sarah Carroll. There we are. I think that's rather nice, actually, isn't it? Shout out to Hamza. John's saying it's impossible to have debt as a devolved government. That means we start with zero debt. We achieve 9.6% of the UK debt, which is currently 1.68 trillion. We didn't sign up for it, so we cannot borrow. Marvellous stuff. Good to have you back listening to you on the radio, says Stephen Gamble. Dinky-doo, Stephen. Fit like the night, man, says George Duncan. I fit like yourself, George. Who's your dues, eh? What's happening? And who else have we got? Who else have we got? How many hats have you got, says Callum Watson? I have stacks and stacks and stacks, but I only wear one at a time. My father always said you could only wear one suit. And loving the Scottish ones, says Peter Ewing. Fantastic. Hamza, a shout out to Isa, no problem at all. And Fletcher says a shout out to Harbert, please. Now, if you're listening round the world, if you're listening in Australia, New Zealand, or Canada, or America, or Tasmania, give us a shout. John Tom says, Dinky Doo, this needs elevated. I'll help out with that. Thank you very much, John. Yes, how's things, Scotty? Hello from Paisley, says David Steele. Hello, my lord. Lovely to hear from you. Bring me in a kebab once you've finished. Kebab. I've been talking to some recently and they said, yes, we can keep the carbs down, Scotty. It would help a lot. So when I have a kebab now, I just say, no, just the meat for me. Thank you very much. No chips. Shout out to Ellie. This is really no problem at all. You should never discuss politics or religion, Scotty. So don't be ridiculous, Margaret. I mean, we discuss football, politics, religion, the lot. That's what it's all about. Hi, Scotty, a shout out to my mum and your auntie. Struan, go and grow up, please. So there we are. You, Struan needs to grow up. And I'm in my allotment, says Den. I think you mean your element. Right, Leo, says Sulman. Fantastic. So a shout out to Leo. If you've just joined us and you're wondering what on earth's going on, it's Scotty McClue with you live on Facebook Live, Sunday nights, 10 o'clock sharp. Tell 10 to tell 10 to tell 10 to tell 10. Now, I make no apologies, but a slight apology to you for sending you through and sharing all the videos from last week all the time. That's only if you're not doing it. Can you please share all these randomly throughout the week and bring a big number to Scotty McClure's program here on Facebook Live at 2200 hours. Anna Pete's watching, Dinky Doo. Dab, Scotty. There we are. Nice bit of dabbing there. Answer your Skype, says Sean. I have answered it, Sean, and you hang up. Shout out to Clark, says Adam. Yes, and a shout out to me and Imogen, says Eleanor. No problem at all, Dinky Doo, I say. Scotty, a shout out to Jim Murphy, wherever he's hiding. You're harsh. You people are harsh. So there we are. Marvel stuff. Right, we've got lots and lots and lots of shout out. Heather Fox is watching. Dinky Doo to you, Heather. Just excuse me a second, folks. Just having another wee tidy up there. A wee mop down. Mm-hmm. That's better. There you are. Look at that. Fresh as a daisy. I'll just have another sip of water. This is what we want. Tremendous stuff. Now, so there you are. I love the stories, but my wife gives me corned beef hash. Could you please tell her the proper recipe? The corned beef hash. Yes. Well, I think the corned beef hash is potatoes, and there should be milk in the potatoes. And I think a dash of salt and a dash of black pepper in the tatties. So there we are. What does that say? I don't know. Yes, yes. Den is weeding in his garden, but there's a lack of light in Scotland, he says. Shout out to Gordon's Support Fund, absolutely. Shout out to my wife and my friend, says Stephen. Yes, no problem at all. Scotty, what's your view on football in Scotland, grassroots football from community clubs like... This is fantastic. Should the SFA change the youth setup? Well, I mean, I don't know football. I mean, I've never been terribly, terribly big in football. Would you like to see Glasgow United? Would you like to see the Celtic and the Rangers come together? So there we are. Simon, you need to grow up. White or red wine, says Den. Well, I don't drink Den. So there we are. I have had a refreshment in my life, and I haven't bothered with anything since last year. Scotty, you're the double of Winston, and you're still game. I don't know if you saw Still Game the other night, but it was absolutely splendid. It was really quite funny, very, very funny, in fact. Sorry, Scotty, I'm just in from the pub, so I'll see your full show tomorrow. Shout out to Sherman, says Matthew. Do you think single mums are the scourge of society? Says Lisa Wilson. Well, you know, the single mum, that's up to herself. The only thing is, you know, women are very, very shy people until they want a baby, and then men have got to go to bed with a duffel coat on, you know. What about poor Morton yesterday? They did Brill, a proud Greenockian. Margaret, absolutely, Margaret. You know, I'm just thinking how well Morton are doing. They've always been a tremendous team. They really have. Terrific stuff. So there we go. I was going to see Morton play one time, and I said to the policeman, "How do I get to Capilou?" And he said, "If you just follow the crowd, sir." Ended up in Morrison's. So there you go. Your views on plastic surgery, says Den. Well, Den, I've never actually had it. I prefer the real thing. Yes, says Matthew. Excellent stuff. And the young team, a shout out to the young team from Adam. How marvellous. So there we are. Thank you for all your shout outs tonight. But it would be quite good to have a discussion. And I'll see, would you like me to sit further back? You can put all your comments onto your Facebook. This is the beauty about it. I mean, this is national, this platform. It's just tremendous. Well, international, you know, I mean, it's global. A big shout out to all my co-workers in Motherwell, says Sarah. Dinky do to you, Motherwell. Absolutely. And what to do, guys, is to let us know. Aha! The real Scotty, says Adam. Yes, it's very strange because on social media people say, "I don't believe you're Scotty McLeod. He stays in America. He's in Hollywood." Do you think the big pharma companies worldwide know the cures for cancer but would rather treat it than cure it? Money, money, money. Well, you know, all this is very, very interesting, but it would depend, of course, on the cancer. You know, I mean, you know, just because somebody treats something, that's not necessarily a cure. But yes, of course, there's money, money, money floating about. You know, that's why they don't like homeopathic medicine. You know, that sort of thing. And what else have we got? Ryan says a shout out to Sonia. And hey, dude, says Bobby McAllister. So fantastic. There we are. Stuart, he says, vape, don't smoke. Well, vaping's marginally better, but if you can avoid either, I mean, tremendous. You don't want to suck stuff into your lungs that's not meant to be there. So there you are. White socks, what do you think? I've told 10 to tell 10 to tell 10 to tell 10. Right, what else have we got? Keep your messages coming. And as I say, we're hoping to discuss the Highland clearances. So we'll find out, we'll see if we can get. We might look at the messenger or what have you, but it would be good to get the calls. I look at social media and I think, can you imagine if all that could be vocalized? You know, people sitting type, 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 typing when they could be talking, could be discussing all this live on social media. It would be tremendous. Now, if you're feeling flush, I don't want to bother you with this, but if you're feeling flush, everybody has been so kind and so generous. If you're feeling flush, if you go to www.scotty-mcclue.com, there's a wee PayPal if you want to make a donation to the program. I use that to buy equipment and things like that and see if we can jack this program up a bit. All right. What I would suspect, what I would ideally like, you know, before I get too old, for goodness sake, before I get too old, what I would ideally like is to try multi-platforming social media so that everybody is listening on their phones as they're walking about. So say we had a morning show on from 9 till 10 or 11 or something like that, and everybody's talking on the phones and everybody can interact with Scotty McClure. And I put this to senior executives and development executives in a lot of the social media companies, and they don't quite understand. I mean, I got in touch with somebody at a television company and I said, "You want to put this program on in the evening on your television company?" And, well, that's not something. Something we'd thought about, you know. You think, for goodness sake. And then I remember somebody was starting up a television company in a major, major part of the world. And I said to them, well, would you not be better trying a phone in? And they said, well, I fail to see how a Scottish phone in would work on a major city television network well away from Scotland. And I was talking to a very, very experienced broadcast executive, and he said, how are you getting on, Scotty? What's happening? He said, are people snapping you up? And I said, well, it's all a bit slow because radio's changed, it's become a jukebox, and they don't have personalities anymore, and blah, blah, blah. And we gave it all this chat. I mean, I'm absolutely fine about it, but just that's the way things have gone. I'm just giving you the facts here. And I said, I got in touch with a guy who's running a television station. I said, and he's got no viewers, or very few viewers. And I suggested to him, why not put McClure on? He said, ah, well, I fail to see. And he said, well, that's why he's got no viewers. He shouldn't be in that job. So there you are. What do you get? Oh, for goodness sake, if you. What do you think about the government and air ambulance? What about the government and air ambulance getting no funding? Well, air ambulance, of course, should always get funding. You know, we should be collecting that. But the lifeboats, you see, the RNLI, they're relying on it as well. Need to hit the sack. Really enjoyed the show tonight, Scotty, especially the Morton joke. Fantastic stuff. Yes, you know Greenock well, I'll tell you that. Scotty, me and my former pal Jack and former members of Merksworth, Scotty. The Merksworth Taping Society, and we remember you well. This is lovely. This is a school where they used to tape the show, and the teachers took tape home and brought it back. Scotty, are you a Fenian or nah? Well, you need to know about the background to the Fenians and to the Irish Brotherhood and all that sort of stuff. You need to know about Eamon de Valera and things like that. So I'm afraid I don't go in for all this left, right, and different religions and all that sort of stuff. We are all Jock Tamson's bairns, and we should respect each other's position. Finally, getting to watch the show live, Scotty. It's great stuff. Says John Paul Preston. Thank you very much, John Paul. A shout out to John, says Fletcher. Yes, John Fitzpatrick, no problem at all. Should you pay your TV license? You have to pay your TV license by law. Now, I would love a company like that where you set it up and by law you pay your TV license. And that was set up by a Glaswegian. That was the British Broadcasting Company. And then they changed it to the British Broadcasting Corporation. It started off with four employees in 1922. Fantastic stuff. All the best. See you next week, says Gordon. Night, says John Toms. Good night to you, John. God bless you. And Donegal is beautiful, said Dan. I know Donegal very, very well. I know all of Ireland, and I've swum in Galway Bay with my big black Labrador. So cheers, big boy, says Fletcher. That's it, guys. We're running out of time. I think I'll leave it at that, and I'll say thank you very, very much. Now, if you're up for it, let me know this week. We need to get the figures up. Get watching, get watching, get watching. We're hoping to be 30,000 after tonight, 30,000 of you. Spread the word, tell 10 to tell 10 to tell 10 to tell 10 about Scotty McClure. A shout out to Ryan from Callum. Yes, absolutely. What are you streaming for? Says Sean. I'm streaming for the world. We're saving the world, Sean. I'm giving the world a sense of hope. Right to all of you, I hope you have an absolutely fantastic week. Enjoy it. From me, Scotty McClure, and the rest of the crew here, which is just me, may I wish you all dinky do. Have a wonderful week. And as I say, we'll hopefully, Godspeed weather permitting, catch up at 10 o'clock sharp next Sunday night. And we'll see what's what. Get OAPs off the buses. Workers need seats, says Den. Thanks, Scotty. Love the show. See you next week, says Charles. Charles, thank you very much for all your kindness this week. So good of you. And to every single one of you who sent a few quid through, thank you very, very much indeed. This is Scotty McClure saying to you, dinky doo. And I'll leave you with the song. It's time for the song. Goodbye, everybody. Goodbye. Take care, everybody, as you go. Goodbye, everybody. Auf Wiedersehen. Au revoir and a cheerio. Dinky-doo.